You want to know how to create some awesome vector textures in Adobe Illustrator? Then keep watching. What's up, designers? Matt Roberts here. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to be taking a look at how to create some awesome vector textures in Adobe Illustrator. So, how do we create better textures? It's a question I get asked all the time. And today I'm going to be sharing with you three ways that I like to use to create better textures for my illustrations. But before we get started, don't forget to smash that subscribe button. We post new videos every Wednesday sharing with you tips on helping you become a better designer. Also, in the description box below, I've added a link to one of our premium texture packs that you can download absolutely free as a thank you for joining us today. So, let's get started. The first thing that we're going to want to be doing is make sure that a document is set up correctly to be getting the best out of the textures that we're going to be creating. So for this, I recommend putting into CMYK mode because the textures that we're going to be creating, we're going to be using the varied intensities of black to actually create the effect. So this just allows us to manipulate the level of black a little easier. So to do this, we're going to go to File, Document Color Mode, and then CMYK Color. Once we've got that, we're going to come over to Color and just make sure that we are switched over to CMYK because you may be in RGB. Now we've got our document set in CMYK mode, I'm going to be showing you how to create each of the textures that we're going to be using, and then we're going to look at actually how to implement them into our illustrations. So to do this, I'm just going to run through how to actually create them and how you actually get the varying levels of intensity. So I'm going to use a couple of circles to show this. So I'm going to create two circles, one that I've got the black level set to 50%, and in this other one I'm going to use the standard black to white gradient fill in Illustrator and just make sure that it's down to CMYK, and then we're going to be using the grain feature. So if we come up to effect, scroll down to texture, and then if we click on grain, that'll bring up this dialog box where we can actually alter the intensity and the contrast of the effect to actually generate something that we would want to use on our illustrations. Once you've got something that you're happy with, click on OK, and then we will have our applied grain there. Now we've got the gradient one, and this one you're going to be able to actually see the varying levels of intensity to add that depth to your textures and actually add shading. So we're going to use Command Shift and E to apply the same effect to this, and as you can see, it's applied the same effect to this, but it's got this varying level of intensity across it. Whilst the effects are in this stage, they are actually still, you can manipulate them, they're still live, so you can just play about with it until it's something that you're happy with. Once you have got something you're happy with, we're actually going to convert these into vector textures. And to do that, first we've got to start by rasterizing each of them, and to do that we're going to go to Object, Rasterize. These are typically the settings that I use, but once we're happy, I'm just going to hit on OK. And then I'm just going to do the same with this other one. Once we've done that, to actually vectorize these textures, I'm going to be using the image trace function inside of Illustrator. So if you've not got the image trace option up here, you can find it under Window and then down to Image Trace, and then that will bring out this dialog box here. Typically, I use the sketched art preset as my foundation to all this, but you can store your own presets to do this from. And then typically I'll alter the threshold and the noise to dial in the effect to somewhere where that I'm happy with. Once I've got something that I'm happy with, I'll hit expand, and that outlines everything and creates into paths that you can actually edit and color to match your artwork. And we're just going to quickly do the same with this other one. So now we've done that, that's our first texture created. So the second texture we're going to be creating is using the graphic pen effect. And you can find that under Effect, Sketch, and then Graphic Pen. And we're just going to follow exactly the same steps that we've just been through. So I'm just going to fast forward through that now, just so you don't have to sit through it again. There we have it, using the graphic pen effect to create some awesome textures. Third awesome texture that we're going to create is using the color halftone effect. And to find that, we go onto Effect, Pixelate, and then Color Halftone. I'm going to repeat all the previous steps that we've just been through, and I'm going to see you on the other side. So, there we have it, three different ways of creating awesome text that you can add to your illustrations. Now, we're gonna take a quick look at how you can actually add these to your illustrations and actually make them usable textures. So, this is an illustration I've been working on recently where I've been using some of these techniques to add a texture to the illustration. So, as you can see, I've got varying different types of texture in there, creating a bit of depth and dimension to the piece. So, I'm gonna hide all of these texture layers and then I'm gonna show you how I've actually created some of these. So now we've got the artwork clear, I'm gonna take one of these color sections and I'm gonna create a new layer on top. Once I've created the new layer, I'm gonna paste my copied color section onto this layer. Once I've done that, I'm gonna add a gradient to it. And I want to look at the gradient to try and look where the light would be coming from in respect to the rest of the illustration. So you can either use the gradient tool and actually drag it through or manipulate it using the options in the control panel on the gradient. Once we've got a gradient that we're happy with, I'm going to use the grain effect to create the texture on this layer. So I'm going to come to Effect, Texture, Grain, and then we're going to have a look. And then we're gonna alter the intensity and the contrast to create an effect that we want to add to our illustration to add that depth and dimension to it. Once we've got something we're happy with, okay. And then we're gonna follow the same steps as before. We're gonna go to Object, Rasterize, hit okay. Once you've done that, don't worry about the big white box. When we image trace, that'll disappear. We're gonna come on to Image Trace, and then once we've got that, we're gonna go to Sketched Art, and then I'm just gonna dial in the texture that I want to add to this. So, cool. Once we've got something that we're happy with, we're gonna expand that, and then it's time to color it. So depending on the light and the dark of your illustration, I typically start by sampling the color that's near it, and then I will take it and darken it up a little if it's a dark area to add that little bit of depth to the illustration. So there you have it, how you add some awesome texture to your illustration. Thanks for watching, designers. If you like this video, smash that subscribe button, give it a like, and also don't forget to ring that notification bell so you get notified every time we post a new video. And also, before you leave, don't forget about grabbing your free texture pack in the description box below. What's up, designers? Matt Roberts here. Welcome back to the channel. Today, why, when you always start filming, does that happen?